Hello everybody and welcome back to a brand new episode of the NASCAR Heat 5 Career Mode. I hope you're all having a great day. Today we have racing in the NASCAR Legends Series, Truck Series, as well as the Cup Series for the second round middle race of the playoffs. As we have some breaking news again to start this episode, and that is Dale Earnhardt Jr. and Jimmy Johnson are announcing their plans to shut down Earnhardt Johnson Racing at the end of this season. Quote, "We had a great run, but want to focus fully on the Xfinity program." So Johnson won't be, of course, involved with the Xfinity program of Junior Motorsports, but William Byron will be back in the 24 car next season as Gary Owen moves to Roush LeBron Racing. So not really a huge change there, as Byron used to drive that 24 car before I moved over to that car, of course, in our third season of our Cup Series career. Earnhardt Johnson Racing, they picked up, I think it was 3 wins they have gotten in their Cup Series career, but this season has been miserable, just like it has been for Goin Racing, and similar situation to the Goin Racing team. We wanted to just shut down and focus on our lower series programs, because clearly we don't have what it takes right now to be competitive on the Cup Series side. Now, as it is looking like Daniel Suarez is going to end up being the driver, I think, for either Trackhouse, or he is going to be in our Xfinity Series program with Goin Racing, so he wouldn't actually go away from Goin Racing fully. So not sure, but those are the two options that it has been narrowed down to for Daniel Suarez now. Those are the options he has on the table. But here we are in the NASCAR Legends Series race. This is actually the cutoff race to advance into the Final Four for a bunch of drivers. Some drivers trying to win their way in. Jonathan Goodell, he is going to be in the Final Four. Kyle Larson is looking like he's going to be in the Final Four. Ricky Stenhouse Jr. right now looks pretty well. David Shoto, he was actually running up at the front of the pack, about second, third area, but he was in a must-win situation if he wanted to advance into the Final Four, just like he did last season in the NASCAR Legends Series. But it wasn't enough for David Shoathouse, because we came through to the final lap and Jonathan Goodell once again would go to victory lane as we come through 3 and 4 for the final time up the inside of the 9 of Chase Elliott. Not enough for him. It's going to be an 8th place finish for us here at the Charlotte Dirt Track, and David Shoathouse, like I said, comes up just short there of a victory, as he would actually finish runner-up here from Charlotte. So very close for him, just not quite close enough. Kyle Larson, Ricky Stenhouse Jr., and Jeff Gordon will be joining Jonathan Goodell in the Final Four. So that is very cool. Jeff Gordon is going to have a chance to get a championship here in the NASCAR Legends Series as we come through into the Truck Series race here now from Talladega Super Speedway. We had community member Isaiah Darkbreath in the truck for us here today. Now starting on the back row, of course, from Talladega, a lot of work to do. And it's been an incredible season for us in the Truck Series, and just a few races are left before the Final Four cutoff race. So not a lot of time for a lot of drivers to get stuff done, but for us, it's looking great. We really don't have to worry too much. We're really comfortable with the points and whatnot. If we just keep what we're doing, we should easily make it into the Final Four here in this season again. And I think that'd be like the third season at least in a row of making it into the Final Four for the Truck Series. So you can see that Isaiah was moving his way throughout the field, just making up a lot of progress here in the early laps of this race. It slowed down a little bit towards the end, but he had made a big four wide move through the middle right here. Help from the draft from Angela Rutschen, that would allow him to get clear on the inside. And by the time he got towards the final lap of this race, he had actually clawed his way into the top five. And by making moves like that, aggressive moves there, going for a hole that really wasn't there, but making it work. And by the time he came through on this final lap into turn 3, a move for second place over the 23 truck now, as Tanner Gray leads the way through turn 3 out of turns 4. But is it going to be enough here for Isaiah Darkbreath out of turns 4? He's going to need some help if he wants to beat that number 15 truck down into the Triumphal for the final time. He covers the inside, so it's going to make it very hard. He has to jump up to the top or hope a hole opens on the inside just like that right there, but it's not going to be enough. It's going to be a second place runner-up finish here for Isaiah Darkbreath in the Truck Series from Talladega Super Speedway. So overall, of course, we cannot complain about a second place finish at Talladega, because that is going to be really good for the point situation, which I had just, of course, been talking about recently here now in the Truck Series. This is looking really, really good for us now, as we're going to see what that grid looks like after you see Riley Herbst, by the way, at the very bottom of the grid. But here is the playoff grid as of Talladega being complete, 48 points above the cut line. So there's no way we're getting eliminated now at this point now, as that second driver is Gutierrez, and he's only 11 points above the cut line. So now we come through into the Cup Series here from Darlington. Now a track that I have kind of talked about recently, saying this one could go either way. This is the round of the playoffs that I've been the most concerned for, because you just don't know what's going to happen. Chicago, I suck at, and I proved that somehow. We managed to get a top 10 last episode at the very end. Darlington. It can go, like I said, either way. We can run top 10, top 5, have a good finish, have a miserable day, run 25th. And Talladega, of course, you never know what to expect there either. So this qualifying lap is pretty good. The goal was a 29.352. I hit a 29.328. And we qualify P9 for the Darlington Raceway Southern 500. So a very strong effort to start off the episode. As you see on pole, we got Todd Gilliland, who's been really showing some serious speed for that front row Motorsports Mercedes car lately here in the grid order. Now you as well see Ryan Blaney down towards 30th place. Kyle Larson, our teammate there, the only teammate we have left in the playoffs, down in 31st place as Tyler Reddick is at the bottom of the grid. All right, boys, I cannot believe we got a top 10 out of it in Chicago. I think that just builds the confidence and proves that we can do just about anything at this point. So let's have a good one tonight. There you hear myself on the radio as we check out the playoff grid. Austin Cindric sent to the back along with Christopher Bell. No impact on the playoffs now. As we look at that playoff grid, like I said, Christian Eckes right now, he's 22 points above the cut line, so he's looking pretty good. And of course, everybody above him, including myself, are looking decent at least. Now, Eric Jones is out by 11 points. Lewis Hamilton is out by 11 points. Derek Krause out by 7. Harrison Burton out by 3. Joey Logano in by 3. And Kyle Larson now is only in by 10 points as we get ready to take the green flag for the second race of the round of 12 here from the NASCAR Cup Series playoffs at Darlington Raceway. The green flag is out. We are underway behind that number 2311 racing driver of Bubba Wallace in that DoorDash Toyota Camry. So a driver that I have been talking about a lot. He's been very strong, and I had actually covered his average finish lately since those regulation changes back at the Charlotte Roval Inn. He's had a very good average finish, and he's just going to be one to watch out for throughout the rest of this season here now as the playoffs at this point full swing, everybody going for everything they can get at this point. There you see Brandon Jones in that number 96 AlphaTauri Toyota Camry, picked up his first win of the season, first win for that AlphaTauri team as well in the last episode at Chicago. They didn't have a car capable of dominating that race. They didn't have a chance to run away from anybody. They just got themselves in the right position at the right time on a late race restart, and that allowed them to be in position to win the race. And as well, he had to hold on a, I think, what, 2-lap dash to win that race as well. So it wasn't like he lucked into the win now as we go down into turn 3. Sam Mayer was the dominant driver, though, in the last episode, and that's what we're seeing right now. He's up there in second place in Darlington, right behind Todd Gilliland. Actually, an exact replica of last episode in Chicago. Todd Gilliland led a bunch of laps very early on. Sam Mayer would take the lead and run away, but it looks like right now Sam Mayer starting to back up to his teammate of Eric Jones, but he would take the lead, though, from Todd Gilliland before he got passed by Eric Jones. I'm over here clawing my way through the field, or at least trying to. We were now at the inside of the 19 of Harrison Burton. Kyle Busch just behind myself in 11th place, and he is getting closer and closer to his first season in the Cup Series ever without a win now. He is running out of time very quick as we got past the 16 of Justin Haley up the inside of Derek Krause. Now, got to be careful with a guy like Krause. He's 7 points below the cut line coming into this race, so don't want to get too aggressive with him. Don't want to do anything stupid now, as we would actually follow him past his teammate of Bubba Wallace here on lap 7. So Bubba falling down the order a little bit now as a caution would actually come out a few moments later for the first time here today for the Southern 500. So nobody coming into the pit lane this time, and that could actually be a bit of a mistake because it is going to put us close on fuel, but not close enough now, as Noah Gregson, though, is coming into the pit lane, so he might have been the reason for the caution, not 100% sure. Tyler Reddick as well is going to be coming into the pit lane, so one of those two drivers definitely brought out the caution. Noah Gregson will return to Chip Ganassi Racing in the next season, by the way. Now, miserable a few seasons it has been for him recently. Now, as we are back underway, it's going to be 17 laps to go in this first and opening stage. A very long race here in Darlington for the Southern 500, and you just got to keep that in mind at the early parts of this race. And when we're at a track, say, a normal mile and a half or something like that, of course, this is not a mile and a half track, but very close. But if we're at a track like Las Vegas, Homestead, Miami, Speedway, or something like that, you know, we're going for it the whole time. But when you're at a track like Darlington, you know you got a lot of time, and it's a very tough track, of course, tough to tame, the nickname for Darlington Raceway. So it's just all about keeping our car in one piece, making sure we don't make any over-aggressive, stupid moves at this point. And it was working out, because now after completing 12 laps, we're up into the fifth position here, and that is exactly what we need here today, is just a strong top 5, top 10 run to solidify our spot into that round of 8 going into Talladega, so that way we won't have to worry. If we can go in to Talladega 25 plus points above that cut line, I'll be very confident with our option or opportunity to make it into that round of 8. So unfortunately, after we got got to fifth. We went nowhere. Lap 23 comes around, and the top three drivers had driven away from myself and Chase Elliott. It was Sam Mayer, Eric Jones, and Todd Gilliland. Eric Jones comes into the pit lane at the end of lap 23. I would actually decide to follow through on the next lap when I saw Todd Gilliland coming into the pit lane. So everybody getting ready to make their pit stops here. We get down without speeding. So how about that? I actually got onto the pit lane under green flag conditions without speeding, but we actually take four tires, two cans of fuel, and beat the number 38 of Todd Gilliland out of the pit lane. And you saw how far behind him we came in, and there was no traffic that we really had to deal with, so I was actually just shocked that we beat him out of the pit lane. And here comes Eric Jones, who pit a lap earlier than myself. He's just now coming through down this back straightaway, and it's going to be very close into turn three. He almost drives right into the back of myself and actually pulled off the track because I thought he was about to destroy me, and that would actually allow him to get back past around me. So we would settle in here to, I think, in a provisional second place position here, and we're about to find out as we go down into turns one. There you see the number 99 of Ross Chastain, the number 9 of Chase Elliott, and that Napa Auto Parts Chevrolet McLaren. And there is Sam Mayer, who was leading originally when the pit cycle started. Not anymore, because Eric Jones and myself are going to go through on the inside. So unfortunately, as we came through to start the final lap of the stage, you can see 7 drivers had stayed out, including Noah Gregson, who pitted under that last caution. He's going to win the stage, and that's going to force 8th place on back, including myself, a lap down at the end of stage 1, which caught us all completely off guard. Now, as Hamilton appears to be trying to pit there, we all have to check up. Jones ran into the back of him. Hamilton comes into the pit lane. I lost so much momentum that there goes the number 66 of Sam Mayer on the outside, and Todd Gilliland is going to get us at the line as well. So all of a sudden, we end up getting an 11th place finish instead of P8, so we just gave up 3 points. And that doesn't sound like a lot, but when it comes to the playoffs and the amount of points we came in above, 3 points is a lot today at Darlington. So, I mean, in Talladega, if we find ourselves getting eliminated by just a couple of points, this is a moment we're going to look back to right there. So that could be quite detrimental to our season now, or playoffs, to say the least. Now, as you see the rest of the order, there was a lot of playoff drivers that did not get stage one. So it's not a huge hit for us, of course. I mean, Eric Jones got a few more, Sam Mayer as well, but that's really it now, as the majority of the playoff drivers, including myself, would not be able to get stage one. So a very interesting strategy to look at here. Jones gets a lucky dog, so he'll be back on the lead lap. That'll be the only playoff driver on the lead lap. But now we all stay out, and we're still forced to lap down because Lewis Hamilton, who pitted coming to the checkered, gets to stay out. So as we start stage two here in Darlington, it is time to get amped after a wild stage one. There you saw it all in amp right now in the 18th position behind Sam Mayer. And unfortunately, for the first 2 laps of this second stage, we were trapped on the outside. And if you can't find a way to the bottom, you're just going backwards the whole time. So, and that's exactly what you're seeing right here, as I got a little bit sideways, got into the side of the number 12 of Chase Briscoe, who's just behind his teammate of the 22 of Joey Logano. But fortunately, the 42 of Tyler Reddick, who's on the lead lap in 7th place, is really slow. So that would allow myself to go around him on the outside there. A future teammate of ours, by the way, as you guys know at this point. Now, though, as we came through to lap 3 of the stage, we were making this inside work. We were making some good time, just trying to position ourselves into a spot to get the lucky dog now. That's all this race is now, is to try and get the lucky dog. So up the inside of Bubba Wallace, I was being a little bit aggressive, overdriving the entry of the corners a little bit now, as we would get up the inside of the number 4 of Ty Gibbs, or sorry, number 11 of Ty Gibbs in the 4th position, that is, as we go down into turn 3, clearing him, no problem. Of course, not a pass for position. Then we would run down Austin Cindric as well as Justin Haley. actually got into the wall right there in turn three, made a little bit of contact with the 33. Then the caution comes out. 10th place of Kyle Busch is going to get the lucky dog. So that is not what we wanted to see. We were hoping it was going to take a lot longer for that caution to come out, but unfortunately it didn't quite play out the way we were hoping. So now we're going to be trying to lap down in some mixed strategy right there. I eventually decided to come in and throw four tires on the car as well as two more cans of fuel. So we lost a lot of track position, of course, but hopefully the way this strategy works, the only way this strategy is going to work in our favor is if it stays green for the final 16 laps of the second stage. Now, Bubba Wallace up my inside. We weren't the only one coming into the pit lane right there. So, of course, it's an opportunity for multiple drivers, not just myself here, as we come through turns one and out of turns two. But the guys that stayed out cannot make it to the end of stage two. So this is how it works in our advantage now as we go down this back straightaway into turns three behind Justin Haley there in that colleague racing Chevrolet as the caution comes out. No idea why. Nothing happened in front of us. And I looked in the replay mode. Behind us, nothing happened. So I am not really sure why a caution is out on the track right now. But nobody's coming into the pit lane, so that does help us. But unfortunately, two cautions is actually going to get it even closer for the guys that haven't pitted at all here in stage two to make it to the end of stage two. So now it's a close call, a gamble for them to still try and risk it to make it to the end of the stage. So we get back underway, and now I'm just like, I don't know what's going to happen at this point, because our only chance is it stays green, but we only have 12 laps to go at the same time, so there's still that potential for some of those drivers to make it to the end of the stage without pitting. Logano there up my inside as we come through the center of one and two, and once again just being trapped on the outside, it just doesn't help us whatsoever. And then I make a slight mistake right there scraping that outside wall here, but finally we get to the inside again as we go down into turn three all the way down in 35th place. But look at this, we make up a good chunk of positions right there just by going down onto the apron, and that is completely legal. And I actually take advantage of this a couple of times now, as I'm noticing we have a lot of big stack ups, and that's because a lot of the drivers on the lead lap were very slow cars, and including that 42 of Tyler Reddick, so it was slowing, of course, down the majority of the fast cars, and that allows myself to take advantage and try and get myself into a lucky dog position before the second stage comes to a close, or, of course, preferably the whole stage just stays green here. That's, like I said, our only chance to get back onto the lead lap without a lucky dog, and we were nowhere close into being positioned for the lucky dog, and, well, the caution decides it's going to come out, and that completely ruins our strategy, as you do see a few drivers electing to not pit, but at this point with a third caution, everybody's going to be able to make it to the end of stage two anyways that doesn't pit. So our strategy got ruined right there, and we didn't get the lucky dog, so it might have been just better off staying out for us earlier there when that caution came out and fighting for the lucky dog right off the bat instead of trying to, of course, hope for no caution. So now we at least move into the lucky dog position here in 13th place, lining up on the outside in 13th place. Now as the green flag is back out, and this time it's just four laps to go, not five to go. It is four to go because we're still one lap down here in stage two. So if we can just stay right here, we'll be able to at least get the lucky dog and claw our way through the field in stage three and get a solid finish out of it now, as Ross Chastain's up our inside. Our rival Joey Logano's right on our back bumper, pushing us on the exit of the corner. Thank goodness that did not turn into anything, but he is still going to be right on my back bumper into turn three, and I knew what was coming. I was completely off the throttle, fully on the brake just about here, just hoping that he doesn't put us in the wall. He's on my bumper the whole corner. I didn't even touch the gas pedal until right there on the exit of turns four. That's how fast he was pushing me through the center of the corner, and he's still on my back bumper, but thank goodness a chance to go down to the inside. He goes sliding into the outside while I go sliding into the side of the 42 of Tyler Reddick. He's sideways. He saved it. Logano saves it as well. We all save it and keep it going in the right direction, but look at the track position we lost. We come through to two laps to go in the second stage. Ross Chastain, Bubba Wallace, the two drivers we have to pass here to get into lucky dog position. Now we're coming to the final lap of stage two, and well, we have an obstacle. That's the three of Austin Dillon. I would actually try to take a three wide into turns one on the final lap with Austin Dillon. Into the corner we go. We're side by side, some contact with him. Jones in the wall because he decided to try and force the three wide at the last second. Didn't work out for him, and it just made it even worse for us because Ross Chastain would get away, unfortunately. Here's a go down this back straightaway into turn three for the final time. In stage two, Noah Gregson is going to somehow sweep the first two stages outside of that number 23 of Bubba Wallace on the exit of turns four, but not enough there. Ross Chastain in Trackhouse gets the lucky dog. We crossed the line for 15th place. So we were third in line there, a lap down. So a lot of work to do going into stage three now, as this race has gone far from good for us here today in the Southern 500. Definitely frustrating, to say the least. And now you can see, once again, we got more mixed strategies. Actually, I said Noah Gregson won the stage, but Kyle Busch got him in the last moment. So no, Kyle Busch wins stage two. Instead, he's coming into the pit lane. I didn't know exactly what to do, but I saw a bunch of guys a lap down were pitting. So I decided, okay, we're just going to come in, throw four tires on the car, two cans of fuel, no adjustments. The car was driving fine. The car had good speed. We easily have a top five car here today in Darlington. We proved that in the early stages, but of course, anything that could go wrong has pretty much gone wrong here since the later stages of stage one. Now, as we are back underway for the start of stage three, and Joey Logano, unfortunately, is on the very row behind me. And I was very concerned when I saw that as we make this charge down towards turns one. 33 laps to go for us here in the Southern 500. Gregson back out in front now. There's a little bit of contact made there with the 22 of Joey Logano, but he gets by us. And unfortunately, we're once again trapped on the outside. And you can't, like I said, do much on the outside unless someone on the bottom is extremely slow. So we're just on this train to the back now and looking for an opportunity to get to the inside. A lot of contact there in the turn three because of these stack ups and whatnot. So I'm just waiting for that opportunity to open up now to get to that inside. But then I clip the wall out of turns four. Don't do actual physical damage to the car, just cosmetics. So that was at least one positive out of that. Now let's go down into turns one side by side with Harrison Burton. And then one positive to take away so far from this race is, although we've had a lot of struggles here with getting the lucky dog being trapped a lap down and whatnot, a lot of our playoff competition as well has been trapped a lap down. Kyle Larson, I don't know how it happened, he is trapped two laps down, so he is completely written out of this race, and he could very well find himself below the cut line at the end of today in Darlington, because there's no way with the current situation with so many cars being a lap down that Larson finds himself on the lead lap, or even a lap down for that matter, before this race comes to a close. Now, as you see on lap 61, myself using that apron again to my advantage now as we get into the top 30. But here comes Joey Logano. I decided to throw a huge block on him. I knew he was going to run into the back of me, but I was like, I'm not dealing with trying to pass you. I'm just going to allow you to push me into the corner. And he nearly takes us out in turns one, but he puts himself in the wall. This is not the first time we've had a run-in with Joey Logano at Darlington. We've had a run-in going for the win a few seasons ago. It might have been last season. Now he's in front of us on lap 62. Haley Deegan blows that right front tire into the wall. She goes. Our AI piles into the side of Anthony Alfredo. The caution comes out nowhere near in position to get the lucky dog. So it's just not looking good for us here tonight in Darlington now, as nobody's going to be coming into the pit lane here. And I myself as well was planning to stay out now. So this is, I think, in my opinion, the last opportunity for us to get ourselves into lucky dog position and hope for another caution, because I feel like if another caution comes out and we're not in that lucky dog spot, we can pretty much write us off at that point because the cautions are so spread out. So it's going to be really tough if we can't get the lucky dog on the very next caution. Now, and that is assuming we do get another caution. And what doesn't help us is not only are we trapped on the outside, but this time the 78 car or 21 in front of them doesn't go. So now a big stack up on the outside and we're trapped on the outside. So we're trying to find a way to get down to the inside as quick as we can. Again, Noah Gregson still leading here in Darlington. This would be huge if he could pick up a second career win in Darlington. But finally, I would get to the inside a lot quicker than the last restart. Make a three wide with Bradinger into turns one. Going for a bit of a power slide there. Nearly some contact with Bubba Wallace. I'm back down on the apron again, just trying to play it safe at that point. I wasn't even trying to gain an advantage. And out of turns two, we find ourselves back in the top 25. We would get all the way up into 19th and then 18th place, passing our Gordon Hendrick Motorsports teammate of Alex Bowman in that Ally Financial 48 Chevrolet. There's some contact with him as I push Gutierrez down this back straightaway into turn three, looking for an opportunity to go by him as well on the outside. So we would do just that. We would also pass Rajat Caruth in the 20 car. So we would move up into 17th place here now, as we were behind the number 44 of Lewis Hamilton, who was falling down the order here on lap 75. No caution yet. It was not looking good, even if we get the lucky dog at this point now, as Noah Gregson continues to lead the way. But we're not even in position to get the lucky dog, so it doesn't matter now. As well, there was the caution with 18 laps to go, and that is going to force us at least, I think, 17th or worse. We are going to come into the pit lane for two cans of fuel. I think four fresh tires because there's really nothing to lose at this point. But I was expecting everybody to actually still do four tires. So Chase Elliott gets the lucky dog. So a playoff driver right there back on the lead lap. Christian Eckes, by the way, he is on the lead lap. This is a big opportunity for him with so many drivers being trapped a lap down. He has a huge opportunity to really increase his gap above the cut line and be just about safe going into Talladega. We lost one spot, and thank goodness we did, because now we are on the inside as the green flag is back out once again. We've had a lot of cautions, a lot of just drama in today's race, and now we are back underway with 14 or 13 laps remaining here from Darlington. Noah Gregson, I mean, you could say has dominated this race. Kyle Busch up into second place, though. We know Kyle Busch, as far off as Joe Gibbs Racing has been this season, they are definitely still better than Chip Ganassi Racing. So I think Kyle Busch is now all of a sudden in a potential spot here to go for a race victory. He's alongside Gregson. If you look up ahead, you can see them side by side as we are now at the inside of Eckes. I'm not wasting any time. I'm trying to get past these guys. And Kyle Busch would get to the lead out of turns four. And I mentioned at the very start of this race, he is at risk of still being in his first ever season ever without a Cup Series victory. But he is now in position to change that now as we went down into turn three on lap 80 here, going up the inside of the 43 of Gutierrez. We got past him. We were alongside Austin Cedric. We are now up into 16th place. The lucky dog position, by the way, as we come through out of turn two now, lap 81. Caught off guard a little bit there by Eric Jones, who would go by on the outside there in that McLaren as we go down into turn three. A big mistake right there. We get on the apron. Sideways we go. We save it, thank goodness. But there goes the lucky dog position right on by Brandon Jones. And we work so hard to finally get into a spot to have a chance to be in that lucky dog spot. And it's gone. We're down into like 24. First, 22nd, 23rd, I think, position now as Sam Mayer goes by on the inside. So we would have to work our way through all of this traffic once again. And fortunately, we have a good enough car that was able to do that. I wasted no time whatsoever working my way through this little pack of cars. And we would do exactly that up the inside of Mayer right there. And Chase Elliott into turn three. We got past Ryan Blaney at the front of the pack. And now behind Joey Logano there in the 18th spot. So we had gotten through them. And we knew at this point, just trying to get a hopeful top 17, top 16. That's about the best we can do now with some contact with Logano on the exit of turn two on lap 85. I wasn't waiting around for him. He shoved us out of the way earlier and ran into the back of us multiple times. So I did not really care with how I raced Joey Logano at this point, but he would repay the favor on lap 86 into turns one, shoves us out of the way into the outside while some contact with the 22 of Joey Logano. He is sideways. He saves it for the time being. Sideways again. There was some contact with the 25 as well, looking to the outside of Joey Logano. Now as we go into turn three, I'm actually going to take him out into the corner now as we're going to have a big incident late in Darlington in the Southern 500. That is about 86 laps of frustration finally being taken out there in one moment. I did not expect the 22 to go around so easily. I was just trying to rough him up a little bit, put him as far to the inside as I could to just mess up his line into the corner. And to my surprise, his car went around like I had clipped him in the quarter panel. So I was really shocked by that. At the same time, I was, like I said, that was a lot of frustration being taken out right there. But now getting ready to go green for just a 2-lap dash to decide this race. Everything that could go wrong in today's race, I think, has gone wrong. I think the only thing we haven't had is a speeding penalty and a car go up and over. And it gets a little bit worse right there is after wrecking Joey Logano, he does not go on the restart because of getting wrecked by myself. So I kind of messed myself over even more, but that was my own fault at that point. Kyle Busch leads the way to turn two, going down the spag straight away now as I overcorrect right there. I lost the back of the car and into the wall I went. As you can see, the car's obviously got a lot of damage there on the front end as we go down into turn three. Just at this point, trying to bring it home now as Kyle Busch leads the way out of turn four down the front straight away. I'm in the wall again. Contact with the 20 of Carruth into the wall. The white flag in the air. Kyle Busch leading the way into turns one and two. We are down to 29th, 30th place under attack from Daniel Suarez for our own Goin Racing team here, as I'm just trying to make sure we don't hit anything now. As Kyle Busch, though, into turns three and four, winless all season long, missed the playoffs for the first time since 2012, and now with less than 10 races to go on the season, he is finally going to return to victory lane. Kyle Busch wins the Darlington Raceway Southern 500. We come through out of turns four, coming to the line. We're gonna barely get Carruth at the line there, and every single point matters after a rough race like that. So that one last second pass on the 20 car could be the difference maker going into Talladega next episode there for the elimination race. As Kyle Larson 38th place. A terrible race for him. He for sure is going to be below the cut line. So we might have a lot of drama going into Talladega in the next episode as we look through the rest of the finishing order on your screen. Chase Elliott there in 10th place. Eric Jones rebounded to 4th place. Todd Gilliland 2nd. Christopher Bell 3rd. If Bell would have made it to this round of the playoffs, he would have really had a nice chance to go compete to get a round of 8 spots. So let's check out the updated playoff grid after that wild race in Darlington. Elliott 45 above the cut line. We are now only 16 points above the cut line. Logano out by 12, Burton by 16, Kraus out by 17, and Kyle Larson out by 18 points. So if one of those drivers wins Talladega, then it's actually a tie with myself and Bubba Wallace now being the last two drivers in. So, I mean, it looks like we're going to be okay if we don't find ourselves in trouble, that is. But it's Talladega, so who knows what to expect. There you see the Final Four grid there for the Legend Series Championship race coming up in the next episode for the Legend Series. So stay tuned for that. Will it be Jeff Gordon, Kyle Larson, Ricky Stenhouse Jr., or a content creator of Jonathan Cadell? We are going to find out now as we, of course, take a quick look at the other playoff grids. There you see, once again, the truck one before going into the elimination race at Martinsville. No truck series in the next episode, though. We got a little bit of time before trucks are actually back. So looking good there for the playoff grid. But then there you see that Cup Series grid one final time. It's going to be a tough race in Talladega. Lewis Hamilton played his cards right with strategy, finds himself above the cut line by 18 points just based off of strategy alone. So if you guys enjoyed, you know what to do. I'd like to thank you all for taking the time out of your day to watch this episode. I really do hope you enjoyed it. It was a lengthy one, one of the longest ones, I think, of the season. So before we end it, just want to say thank you to the Go In Racing members on the channel of MJ, Joseph 9001, Timothy Arline, Bubba Jr., Brett Durward, Dark Gengar Gaming, AJ Vasura, Russell Dixon, Kenneth Barnett, Dana9302, Speeddemon341, as well as Illinois Diecast. I appreciate you guys' support so, so much, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a great day, everybody.